Today, one more Ohm's principle is polymorphism. In previous tutorial, we discussed what is encapsulation. We saw one real-time example. In this tutorial, we'll see polymorphism. It's a real-time example like a mobile phone. Everyone is using mobile phone. Through mobile phone, how polymorphism is happening, we'll see in this tutorial. First of all, as a name itself, polymorphism means many forms. Actually, polymorphism, poly is a Greek word, so you can see in the description. See, polymorphism means it is a Greek word, where poly means many and morph means change, refers to ability of an object taking many forms. Mobile is an object, it can have many forms. Same mobile, the forms like is a 5-inch, 6-inch, 8-inch, like the same object can behave like as a many forms. Okay, mainly polymorphism mainly used in inheritance. We will use like parent class methods are overridden by the child class. This point, if you want to understand, like if you see example, then you will easily understand what is a polymorphism. Okay, polymorphism are two types. First one is method of overloading and method overriding. Overloading is called a compile time polymorphism. Already one tutorial I given in the method compile time polymorphism. What are the interview questions they will chances to ask on, like 3-4 examples I given. You can watch the tutorial that method overloading and method overriding. It is a runtime polymorphism. At the runtime we can call as a dynamic. It will be dynamic batch will call. At the runtime it will be behave which one need to call. So that is called runtime polymorphism. Today I will show you one example. It will be a high level of polymorphism. Just you can have how the dynamic is happening, we can see. Like any number of classes can implement an interface, right? Like each class is free to provide their own implementation. Suppose like mobile is a class, okay. Android is a other class, iPhone is a other class. Like for the Android and iPhone, both common class is what? Mobile. Okay, so mobile has many forms. Like that, we can say one interface has multiple methods. Like that, that is called like a polymorphism. So already I developed one project. I will show you. So yeah, we'll go for just I created a project polymorphism. Two packages I created is a test package. This is a model package. I created model. If you see, observe here, mobile is a class. I have one variable, that is price, mobile price. For Android and iPhone, both have price, right? If Android has 50,000, if suppose iPhone has a 1 lakh, price will be vary. So in super class, like mobile is a super class. It is a super class. So value will be initialized through constructor. Initialized in constructor. CT constructor. So I created one constructor here. This is called super class constructor. This means mobile is a super class. So one base constructor I created with a mobile. So the value is a price. You no need to write this constructors, setter and getter methods. We can generate by using Eclipse. If you go for the source, if you go for here, we can generate setter and getters, two string method, hash code, constructor, everything they given by the Eclipse. No need to write by your own. But in interview perspective, sometimes they will ask to write a constructor, write the setter and getters. In that time, you will be confused to write. So better to practice to write by yourself. Once you are familiar with that one, then you can generate that methods through Eclipse. So mobile class is this is a super class. So we have setter and methods. Here I wrote one method. See, public void calculate mobile price. So this mobile price, Android price is different and iPhone price is different. So I didn't provide any implementation. So
implementation classes can provide that implementation. I no need to, just I given the model I given, calculated is mobile price is a model I given. So go for that Android. So if you go for that Android, here also I wrote one constructor. So I'm carrying super, it's not a cost, it's a price. If you go for the super, so it will call this method. So super anyway, it will be there. So URI is a constructor, is a, if you is a constructor. If you don't give this super keyword, what it is throwing, say implicit super constructor mobile is undefined, must explicitly invoke another constructor. What does it mean? Already you provided constructor in the mobile level, so you need to override that constructor by using the super. So by using super, I'm calculating that price. Okay, here this is my own implementation method. Android has implement own implementation method. Whatever the cost is there, just I'm printing, that is called Android model. This is my own implementation class, Android. Okay, if you go for that iPhone, same as it is, I overrided that constructor I'm calling for by using super keyword. And if you want to call from super class constructor, super class methods, anything, you can use the super keyword. Okay, it's a keyword. This is my own implementation method of the iPhone class, mobile price. What are the getting the price? I want to multiply with the 20. If I have 20,000, just I'm calculating iPhone mobile cost is 40,000. So Android cost is whatever I'm getting input, I'm using same thing. Just if you go for the test class, see, I'm created initially as a null. Initial value for the mobile is null. So I'm creating one Android object, I'm creating one iPhone object. Android value, how much? 20,000 I'm passing. iPhone, I'm passing as 30,000. So anyway, mobile is a super class, so I can assign subclass variables. So if you go for Android is equal to mobile. So mobile class has Android implementation class. Through mobile, this is a overrided method. If I call this method, so it will call which page? If you click implementation, if you see mobile is a super class, Android and iPhone is a subclasses. So one class has one interface has many methods. That means one class has many implementation classes. This is called polymorphism. At the runtime, it will take, if you pass as Android, it will call Android class. If you pass as a iPhone, it will call as a iPhone class. So mobile dot calculated. If you run this program, see Android mobile cost is 20,000, iPhone mobile cost is 60,000. This is called runtime polymorphism. So one in many forms. In the next tutorial, we will see one more example of method overloading and method overriding also. Thank you guys. Please like and share to your friends. Don't forget to subscribe this channel. Please share your reviews on below videos. If you have any doubts, you can send email to this ID. Java Express channel @gmail.com. Thank you guys.